Welcome back, everybody, to the Pittsburgh Pirates franchise here on MLB The Show 20. As we have hit the end of July, and in baseball, that means only one thing. The trade deadline is upon us. Our Pirates are 30 games under 500, which means our trade deadline will mostly consist of trading veteran older players for younger prospects who have more upside down the line, but are less likely to help the team right away. If the season ended now, we would have the third overall pick in the draft. The Mariners and Royals are still worse, believe it or not. As looking at the roster, we're obviously not going to trade everybody who's old and talented. Not even old, but older, as in like 25, 26, 27 in the middle of their primes. Guys like Josh Bell. It doesn't make sense to trade Bell right now. He is a franchise building block for the future. But there are a few other players who could be on the move. One of them is Jason Martin, and he's 23, a young outfielder with upside. So this isn't one of those prime examples of trading an older veteran player for prospects. This is trading a young kid who has 84 potential and could be a starting caliber player in the major leagues. So why exactly is he the first player who is going to be dealt? Well, there is a reason. Looking at the catcher position for this team, nobody has a higher than C potential, but that's going to change right now. Jason Martin is on his way to San Diego, along with outfielder Socrates Brito, currently on the AAA team, and reliever Clay Holmes, in exchange for Francisco Mejia. Mejia has looked like a bust so far in his major league career. This is a guy who was one of the top prospects in baseball, sort of struggled with the Indians, was traded to the Padres and has played better, but the Padres don't really need Mejia. They got Austin Hedges, who's good for the time being, and then Luis Campusano, who's one of the top prospects in all of baseball. So Mejia is sort of the odd man out here, and the Padres are going to be getting a young outfielder and a few other pieces, whereas the Pirates are now getting a catcher who can be the future. For now, he will likely be platooning with Jacob Stallings, and we'll go from there. If one of them outplays the other, the Pirates can always make one of them the everyday guy. But for right now, Mejia should certainly make an impact on the Major League roster. So the next player who's going to be traded is John Ryan Murphy. Looking throughout the season, John Ryan Murphy, for whatever reason, has a lot of trade value in the exploration that I've done. He's going to go to the Los Angeles Angels in exchange for 21-year-old starting pitcher Jose Suarez, a Venezuela native. Jose is a very raw prospect, currently in AAA with the Angels. He played a little bit last year towards the end of the season. But they're currently a contending team for a wild card spot who could use an extra catcher. Meanwhile, Suarez can develop in the Pirates organization. The next player on the move is Chris Archer. This one was an obvious one. Archer's tenure in Pittsburgh hasn't really worked out. He was acquired two seasons ago for Austin Meadows and Tyler Glasnow, who are young, blossoming stars. Archer's on the final year of his contract, and he really wants to go to a contending team, which obviously the Pirates are not. But now he has a chance to go to a team who has a chance to go far. Him, along with Jared Dyson, are headed to the Arizona Diamondbacks in exchange for Seth Beer, a 23-year-old outfield prospect currently in AAA. Beer has not played in the majors yet, but will start in the MLB with this trade. So Beer will likely be a platoon outfielder for the time being. He has a bat, solid defense, but I think his hitting is where he will be valued the most. Is he a long-term building block for this team? I mean, there's certainly a chance at the potential. He's young, and he has a lot of talent, so maybe the Pirates can build around him for their future. And then the final trade involves long reliever Robbie Erlen. Erlen has had a great season, but does not have a lot of trade value. He's going to the Astros along with a few other prospects, second baseman Mitchell Tolman and closer Luis Escobar. They will be traded for Framber Valdez. This is a trade I really like for both sides. The Astros get better right now. They are a World Series contender, and they get Erlen, who's had a phenomenal season, whereas the Pirates Harlan was gone at the end of the year, so now they're getting a young player in Valdez who has a very similar role as a long reliever. Not enough stamina to really be a guy you want in your rotation, but enough stamina where you can have him clutch out 3, 4, 5 innings when a starter is having an off day. A few other corresponding roster moves will be made. Cole Tucker's going to AAA. He has had a very bad season. He has an OPS under 450. That's really bad. So he needs to get his act together in the minor leagues. Replacing him on the roster will be Tim Beckham, who is going to be signed out of free agency. The Pirates don't have any bench infielders, so they needed someone. And there isn't really a great opportunity to call anyone up at this point. So Pittsburgh figured, why not go ahead and sign Beckham, who could be a good bench bat for a year or two. He was a former number one overall pick, and while he sort of has been a bust, he's been a quality player throughout his major league career. The Pirates signed him to a 2-year, $1.3 million contract. He has a club option for the second season, so if things don't work out, the Pirates can just let him go. Brandon Waddle is also moving up to the majors. He will replace the roster spot of Chris Archer. And then, as you can see, a few other corresponding moves have been made as well. As the Pirates open up a 3-game homestand here against their divisional rival, the St. Louis Cardinals, Francisco Mejia will be making his Pirate debut, and Seth Beer will not only be making his Pittsburgh Pirates debut, but he will also be making his Major League debut, which is very, very cool. Here's a look at both lineups, 1-9. Believe it or not, I think the Pirates lineup actually got better as a result of this trade deadline. Like, I'm talking better for this season and the future as well. As on the mound today for Pittsburgh is Mitch Keller. It's been a rough season for the rookie, but the upside is certainly there, and we know that Keller has plenty of potential and room to grow, but the growing pains have been apparent this season. So as long as he can pitch pretty well today, try to get on that groove and finish off the season strong, that's all that matters, as he does strike out Colton Wong. Here's Carlos Martinez on the mound for the Cardinals. He was used as a long reliever the past few seasons, but it looks like he is back fully in the rotation. As there's Adam Frazier, he's just a window shopper because he's just looking. On to the second now, here's Trey Mancini, part of the 3-team deal that was made back in June, sending top prospect Dylan Carlson to Pittsburgh. He's going to go deep into left, 429 feet. The 23rd home run of the season for Trey Mancini, who's been an excellent addition to this lineup, as Matt Carpenter strikes out. But we got a few batters later, another home run for the Cardinals. This one off of the bat of Tyler O'Neill, his 12th of the season, and now it's 2-0. Pittsburgh trying to get onto a roll, as there's a walk for Kevin Newman. So 2-1, no outs for Colin Moran. He's going to rip a double into the right center gap. 2 runs will score, and the Pirates will, just like that, tie the game up. Then here's Francisco Mejia. His first at-bat as a Pirate will be a grounder. It does advance for runner, and that'll bring up Seth Beer. His first at-bat in his Major League career will be a single in a center. Run scores, and that'll be his first career Major League hit and his first career Major League RBI. Josh Bell going out to retrieve the ball for his teammate. Definitely a great That's going to be the first of hopefully many great hits for Seth Beer as a Pirate. As here's an interesting play. Look at Colin Moran. He's going to try to throw home, but Martinez slides safe. Runner on first is safe, but not for much longer. There's Francisco Mejia, part-time ball player, full-time sniper. One of the big calling cards for Mejia is his arm strength. And it shows there as he picks off his first runner as a Pirate. Here's Paul Goldschmidt going deep into straightaway center. His 25th home run of the campaign, as Mitch Keller once again not having a great day. Here's Matt Wieters, though. He's going to tell Mejia, what you can do, I can do better. He guns down Josh Bell at second. So now let's go later. Bottom of the fourth now for Colin Moran. That one gets by the glove of the center fielder. Moran digging for third, and he will be safe. That is his first triple of the season. He's not known as a speedy runner on the base pass, and Moran will tag home safely on the sacrifice fly from Francisco Mejia. So just like that, this game is now tied up at 4. Here is Seth Beer, the next batter. He gets that one in a right field for a base hit, and he is now 2-for-2 and has a career batting average still of 1,000. Couple batters later, it's Brian Reynolds. That ball deep in the center at the track at the wall. And it would be caught to end the inning. Close call there. But the Cardinals are lucky that the Pirates are not up. But now the Cardinals are up as there's Matt Wieters. His second home run of the season. He's not the everyday catcher. That honor still belongs to Yadier Molina. As it is now 5-4. Why not make it a little bit better? As that ball nearly gone off of the wall in right center. Polanco fields it, but that'll be a double for St. Louis. And you got to wonder, when are the Pirates going to take Keller out? There's a single into right. Polanco throwing home, and the throw is going to be way short. So now the Cardinals lead it 6-4. Nice RBI single, and that'll end the day for Mitch Keller. Framber Valdez now in for Pittsburgh. His first appearance as a Pirate, hopefully a good one. And he gets out of the inning successful as nice play at second to end it. So let's go to the bottom of the fifth. It's a two-run game, but not for much longer because Josh Bell exists. Bell cuts the lead in half, his 28th home run of the season, and the 2020 Home Run Derby champ will make it just a one-run game. That'll end the night for Carlos Martinez. Ryan Hesely now in for St. Louis. As here is Colin Moran, currently with a double and a triple. He's going to get an RBI single. Run comes home to score. Polanco is safe. This game is tied, and Moran is now a home run shy of the cycle, and he will get another at-bat. As here's Framber Valdez. He is cooking right now. Gets Paul DeYoung looking, and then Tyler O'Neill will go down swinging. Nice performance in this one for Framber Valdez as we move to the bottom of the sixth. Here is Seth Beer. That one gets kind of by the glove of Paul DeYoung, and Seth Beer is now 3-3. That's worth a chug, if you know what I mean. And then not too long later, here comes up the pinch hitter. He will rip a single, but there's one problem. That's not going to be a single. He tries to run back to first. That's Tim Beckham, by the way. His first at bat as a Pirate, and he would actually end up getting the single because these Cardinals infielders don't know how to play defense. And that will continue as Reynolds gets the base hit off of the bad defense from DeYoung. Here's Adam Frazier. That technically is a single, but Reynolds is out at second. Pittsburgh is up, though, 7-6. And then here's Josh Bell. He is shopping gap into right center field. Two runs come home to score. Bell digging for third. He will be safe. Everybody's safe, and the score is now 6-9. Nice. That's a really nice score. Someone better screenshot that one for the good memories. Cardinals make a well-needed pitching change as Tyler Webb is in. Gregory Polanco, he's going to be gunned down at first. However, Josh Bell will score. So now it's 10-6 as Michael Feliz will enter the game here for Pittsburgh as we move on to the seventh inning. There's a nice shot into the right center field gap for St. Louis as they try to get back in this game. A no-out double, and this is just the opportunity they need to get back in it. And then here's Bell. He's going to try to make the play at the plate, but the runner is safe, Matt Wieters. And just like that, runners on the corner. As the Pirates need to quickly turn two, and that's what they'll do. 4-6-3 double play. The Pirates infield is more chemistry than a science project. New pitcher for the Cardinals, it'll be John Brebbia. I didn't get the initial graphic, whatever. As Colin Moran, he wanted to go yard for the cycle. Unfortunately, he strikes out. And then Seth Beer, his batting average of 1,000 also is no more as he grounds out to second. Colton Wong makes the play. Let's go to the bottom of the eighth. Jordan Hicks in for St. Louis, the flame-throwing righty, as he will get out of the inning successfully. Adam Frazier gets that one right to him, and we move on to the ninth. All right, as Vizcaino is in for the save. He's been more of a setup man, but with Keon Kella gone, he does have the closer role. That ball is high, not too deep into left, and it will be caught by Reynolds, and the Pirates get the win by a final score of 10-7. They improved to 40-69. Nice. As the bats were alive for both teams. St. Louis's offense really played well, but Pittsburgh's was just a little bit better. Big game for all the bats. The Cardinals bullpen played well down the stretch. So did Pittsburgh's. But the starters did not pitch too well. Looking at box score for Pittsburgh, obviously Moran nearly had the cycle. Seth Beer went 3-for-4 with 3 singles. Home run for Josh Bell. Him, Moran, and Polanco all had extra base hits. They all drove in runs along with Frazier, Mejia, and Seth Beer. The win goes to Framber Valdez, his 5th. This Guyano gets the save as we did a little bit of simulating. And now, this was a game that was circled on the calendar for this Pittsburgh team for a while. The Arizona Diamondbacks come to town, which means Starling Marte's return to Pittsburgh. This is the first game of the series, so this is his first game in Pittsburgh. He will be leading off for the Diamondbacks, and he got a standing ovation from the crowd when he went up to bat as Brandon Waddle on the mound for Pittsburgh. This is his second career game. His first one didn't go too bad. 5-1, 3.38 ERA. Here's Starling Marte. He's going to rip a single into right, and there were a decent bit of cheers for that one base hit for Starling Marte, who looks awfully excited as Nick Ahmed will strike out Brandon Waddle, trying to get into an early groove. Speaking of players returning to Pittsburgh, look who's on the mound for Arizona, Chris Archer. Didn't get nearly as many cheers, actually got more boos, if anything, with a mix of cheers as well, as most of those stats are with Pittsburgh. His first game, he's had one game, with Arizona, as the first inning would be successfully for him. David Peralta gets the flyout from Bell. We move on to the second. Carson Kelly strikes out. Ildiarmo Vargas does as well. Bottom two, Colin Moran goes down swinging, and both pitchers are looking really good. Chris Archer and Chris Archer's replacement. There's Ketel Marte. He's going to strike out as we move to the bottom of the third. Something has to give for these hitters, but Ketel Marte says, not on this green grass. He robs Brian Reynolds of a base hit. We move on to the fifth. Chris Archer, he's just a window shopper because he's just looking. Score remains tied at 0. We move to the bottom of the fifth. Francisco Mejia goes deep in a right, and the scoreless tie is no more. His 11th home run of the season, first as a Pittsburgh Pirate, and the Pirates will take a 1-0 lead. Would you look at that? Those two were teammates for probably about 5 minutes. We move on to the sixth. The Diamondbacks are trying to start a nice little inning of their own, and that they would do, as there is a denier for Arizona, none other than David Peralta with the home run. Those words are quite familiar on this channel, and just like that, the D-backs will take a 2-1 lead. Here's Eduardo Escobar later in the sixth, gets that one over the glove of Josh Bell. That'll be extra bases. And just like that, the Diamondbacks' offense is clicking. And Brandon Waddle is starting to slow his roll. But luckily for Pittsburgh, the inning would end shortly after as Reynolds makes the play in center, or in right center, sorry. Let's go to the bottom of the sixth now. Two gone for Gregory Polanco. The Pirates want to start a little bit of a two-out rally, and that they're going to do as Polanco goes deep into center. Ketel Marte is unable to rob it. And just like that, this game is tied up at 2. But ladies and gentlemen, we are not done quite yet. Here's the next batter, Kevin Newman, 2-for-2 so far. Going to make it 3-for-3, his third base hit of the game. And just like that, that brings up quite the opportunity for Colin Moran. And he will capitalize. Moran goes deep into right. So technically, he has the cycle for the episode in a way, as that'll be his 7th home run of the season, and the Pirates will take the lead. Pitching change for the Diamondbacks. Alex Young is in for the D-backs. He would do just fine finishing the inning. As here's Starling Marte, better double check that swing. Brandon Waddle's day would end after 7. New pitcher for the D-backs, Stephen Christian in, as he would get Seth Beer to go down looking. Beer has sort of slowed down after that red-hot start, so two outs now. The Pirates have two runners on. They have quite the opportunity to make this lead even wider, but that they are not going to do, as Josh Bell will line out to the first baseman. We move on to the eighth inning. Davidas Navarauskas, the Lithuanian native, is now in for the Pirates. Nick Ahmed will strike out, so now two outs. The Diamondbacks are in need of some sort of rally And they're going to try to start one as there is a double that'll bring up the tying run up at the plate. Eduardo Escobar, who has the chance to be the hero or be the loser. Escobar strikes out. We move to the top of the ninth. This Guyano on for the save once again here for Pittsburgh, as this first at bat is for Christian Walker. Simple fly out to first, right? Wrong. Josh Bell totally misses it. That'll be an error. And just like that, things are going to get interesting as Carson Kelly draws a walk. The go-ahead run is at the plate. He's going to hit a single. Run comes home to score. And the Diamondbacks are only down by one with two on and no outs. That'll bring up the pinch hitter, Cole Calhoun. He's going to strike out. That's a big one for the D-backs. Two gone now. That one goes into foul territory in the left. Seth Beer will make the play, and Pittsburgh survives barely. They win it by a final score of 4-3. It'll be Brandon Waddle who gets the win. Chris Archer with the loss. Archer pitched really well, I guess, until the sixth inning. He only allowed one run the first five innings, which was the home run from Francisco Mejia. Most of the scoring was done in the sixth inning. The Mejia home run was the only run of the game scored not in the sixth inning. The bullpens did their job, as I don't think any relievers allowed a single earned run, so they did what was necessary. The only extra base hits for Pittsburgh were from home runs by Polanco, Moran, and Mejia. As we would do some simulating, and believe it or not, the Pirates have won more games than they've lost here in the month of August. Currently 53-78. Figured it's a good time to look at the stats. Brian Reynolds hitting .316. That's a great number to be at. Adam Frazier doing solid. Josh Bell still putting up MVP-like numbers. Polanco nearing 30 home runs. Newman is now over 300. Moran solid. Mejia solid. Next up, we got Seth Beer. He's been about average. Jose Osuna, average. Stallings, pretty much average. Tim Beckham's not doing too bad. And then the rest of the bench guys are doing too hot. Now, looking at the pitching rotation, Joe Musgrove is still putting up elite numbers as well. He's had one darn good season. Trevor Williams has been a little bit above average. Not much more than that. Derek Holland is actually starting to pitch a lot better after a slow start. Keller is still not doing great. And Brandon Waddle is not doing too bad. Looking at the bullpen, these ERA numbers are not too great. And the Pirates would make a move in the bullpen, and it involves reliever Emmanuel Clase. Clase was part of the first trade of the series with the Cleveland Indians, and he has not been good this year. 6.37 ERA. I think he needs to get his act together in AAA. And you know who's going to replace his spot on the roster? Kyle Crick. Crick was in the same scenario a couple months ago. He was pitching really badly, sent down to AAA, and he's been pitching a lot better. So Crick will replace Clase in the Major League bullpen, and now Clase will replace Crick in the AAA bullpen. Here's a look at the minor league stats. The big prospects on the AA team are Mickey Moniak, Travis Swaggerty, and Leover Peguero. All three of them are doing very solid. I've been looking at the pitching. Ever since Brennan Malone was called up to AAA, he's been outstanding. 1.53 ERA is a very good number to see. Jose Suarez isn't doing too great. And then the other big prospect is first-round pick Quinn Priester, who has been pretty solid. And then look at the bullpen. Everybody in the bullpen pretty much has a good ERA, which is incredible. And then looking at the AAA squad, we'll start with the pitching rotation, I guess. Adonis Medina isn't doing too bad. Domingo Robles was moved up to AAA at the beginning of the episode. He had a great season in AA, and he's not doing too bad in AAA either. And then looking at some of these ERAs, the bullpen is doing really well here too. Clase is at 3.13. That was the ERA he had with the Indians AAA organization before the trade. So that was all back in April. And then looking at the lineup, Cole Tucker's been meh, I guess. Cabrian Hayes has had a very solid season. Will he get called up next season? That's a tough question. Lazaro Armenteros has played a lot better since the trade, so that's good. Dylan Carlson will for sure be with the Major League club next year. He's been outstanding. O'Neill Cruz is playing really well, too. I think one of Cabrian Hayes and O'Neill Cruz will start the season next year in the majors, and the other one will likely start out in AAA once again. So I think that's the plan with them. Obviously, we have a whole offseason to go through, but that's just my guess. Obviously, we could be wrong about that. Who knows? the Pirates could totally surprise us and just do something random. Here's a look at the rest of the numbers. Tim Tebow has not hit a home run yet. That's kind of sad. He is on the 40-man, so we will see Tim Tebow's debut, likely the episode after the next one. So that'll do it for the video. Next episode, we'll be playing the Phillies. We'll also watch a double-A game, and then for the triple-A team, we're not going to play the Bats or the Mudhens because we already played them this season in games we've watched. So we're going to simulate to the series against the Columbus Clippers. Hope you guys enjoyed. Have a good one. Peace out.